So we are so glad you could come. Our kids have been working really hard to prepare this music for you guys, and we're hoping when you leave here tonight, you're in the Christmas spirit. If that's the case, then you've got it going on, all right? So a little bit about what we're gonna hear. We actually have, it's called a chamber winds class, or chamber class, and chamber music is just designed for small groups of instrumentalists, or could be singers, that are singing in a small area. Right, like a judge's chambers, think of a judge's chambers, as opposed to like a large orchestra or large band. So that's where chamber music came from. So these guys are in, we have two different sections of it. One meets sixth period and one meets seventh period. So they're actually getting to hear each other play tonight too for the first time, which is gonna be fun for them. So I gotta make sure you get your cell phone silenced. They get me too. So tonight's gonna be almost all exclusively Christmas music, so you can sit back and enjoy. You'll hear a whole variety of a bunch of different instruments. The program will actually be announced by each of our performing groups. So they're gonna tell you, except for this, I'm gonna do the first one for them, and then everybody else is gonna tell you what they're gonna be playing, okay? All right, so sit back and enjoy. We're gonna start off with our trumpets. They're gonna be doing a fanfare on Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Some flute ensembles have an optional alto flute part, which is what I'll be playing.
Thank you. We're going to be playing The Christmas Horn Spirit by Mark Papagen.
Some of the songs in it is Christmas is Coming, Ding Dong Merrily on High, Joy to the World, Silent Night, Carol of the Bells, Deck the Halls.
It also has Auld Lang Syne, Angels We Have Heard on High, Jingle Bells, O Come All Ye Faithful, and We Wish You a Merry Christmas.
And our group name is Potato Salad.
Thank you. Hey everyone. We're going to be playing Fantasia on the Ukrainian Bell Carol.
This piece was written by Mykola Leontovich.
This piece was arranged by Kate Akitoris.
Mykola wrote this piece as a part of the Ukrainian independence movement.
So we're going to be playing God Rest You Merry Gentlemen, arranged by Chet Esther. This song features a flugelhorn that's in the conical shape to have a more mellow tone than a trumpet.
This song has a cornet in it, and a fun fact about it is it may appear smaller than a trumpet, but it is, when pulled out, they're both 6.5 feet.
God Rest You Merry Gentlemen was first copyrighted in 1856, but it actually dates back to the 1400s.
Thank you. Hi guys. Today my group is performing American Christmas. It was composed by Jace Pierpont and arranged by Thomas Graff.
This it's like multiple songs in it, so it's called Themes and Variations, because it's multiple songs in one.
So one of the songs that we're playing is called "Den Sommer Land High." It traces back to 1588, which make it about 434 years old.
Thank you. name is the Care Bears.
We're playing Teddy Bear's Picnic by John Walter Bratton.
John Walter Bratton was an American Tin Pan Alley composer and theatrical producer.
The piece was written in 1907 and it represents each generation's love for teddy bears.
It was arranged by Sharon Wilson.
A fact about our composer and the song is it was written by John Ward Jr., whose father was a former slave and musician, and he grew to be one too in his father's footsteps. And he wrote this song in the late 1800s, but it was first published as a book in 1907 called Christmas Carols New.
This particular arrangement was originally composed for two violins and one cello, but we will be performing it with one violin, one cello, one oboe, and one bassoon.
Thank you.
The title of our song is Jingle Bells.
It was originally composed in 1857 by James Pierpont, and it was originally made for Thanksgiving.
Thank you. Okay, we will be playing two movements of the Nutcracker by Tchaikovsky. First, we will be playing Dance of the Moritans and then Overture Miniature.
A fact about Tchaikovsky is that he would conduct with one hand and hold his chin with the other because he was scared his head would detach from his body.
The Nutcracker Ballet was based on a story made by E.T.A. Hoffman in 1816 named The Nutcracker and the Nosegay.
The Dance of the Moritans was also called the Dance of the Reed Flute. The dance was by a small group, 4 to 8 women, or a trio of 2 women and 1 man.
Thank you. Hello.
Good afternoon. We are Opus Number One, Number Three Plus One, and we're going to be playing a piece called Sarajevo.
Sarajevo was composed by Grandma Rago. He's a Barry player, and that's his alternative ego.
So Sarajevo was composed over the Bosnia War that happened in Sarajevo. Sarajevo was kind of like the capital city that happened, and that ended up in a lot of massacre, genocide, and ended up being sieged.
Alright. The next piece we're going to play is a piece by Peter Tchaikovsky called Tripek.
So, it's called, you know, Tripek, and also Russian Dance. So, it was entitled Russian Dance for the simple fact that it was made after a Russian dance, which is actually also shared with the Ukraine as well.
Thank you.
We will be playing Farandole by Georges Bizet.
Georges Bizet was a French composer, and he's best known for his opera, Carmen, which was the last piece he wrote before he died at 37 years old.
Farandole is the most popular movement of a larger play in La Nécienne by Alphonse Daudet. The reason Farandole is played around Christmas time is because it uses parts of a traditional French Christmas carol named March of the Kings.
Thank you.
So before we say goodnight, I wanted to have another round of applause for everybody, so all the musicians, please. So, all the musicians, all the performers, before you leave, we want to get a picture up here in this area. Real quick, I won't take up a lot of time, but just, I wanted to say thank you to Mr. Sanders for being here, the principal. He's the one in charge and makes this all possible for us to have these chamber winds classes. Special thanks to Mr. Dyke. Where are you at, Mr. Dyke? Not only doing this, but also playing. And a big round of applause to the person who makes all of our chamber music happen, Ms. Whaley. So, I want you to note something. As parents, I think you would agree that our goal as parents is to raise our children so that they need us less and less. As painful as that might be, we want them to be okay without us, because they'll be without us soon, as I have found out all too quickly. As teachers, it's the same thing. We hope to teach and train our students to a point that they need us less and less. And I hope you noticed that none of the performances that you saw tonight had a conductor in front of them. It was all them. And during the chamber winds classes, they do all of the work. They might get a little coaching every now and then, just like you do with your children, just like we had to do in the classroom. But this chamber music experience is so very valuable because they learn how to do it on their own. They learn how to rehearse. They learn how to work with each other. They learn how to communicate with each other. And if you were watching, you could tell they physically communicate. They look at each other. They listen to each other. And I promise you, it is the most valuable thing they do as musicians. So I just wanted you to note that, and maybe appreciate what they did even more. So thanks for being here. I'm very glad that you were here with us tonight. I appreciate all of your support. Our Christmas concert is coming up on the 13th. We'll have more Christmas music by these students and more, so we invite you to be here for that. Until then, thank you very much, and Merry Christmas. Happy Holidays.